phase of the project costed 3.659558 billion. Then the second phase cost, that is 3.472116 billion.
Professor Jasper Ogwal Okeng, the University Vice Chancellor, expressed gratitude for the new structure. Ogwal says the university is developing with funds locally generated from the community.
It's being built almost solely by the money generated from the community here, from the students. Lira University does not, staff do not, they do not enjoy that. That allowance that other universities are enjoying. Most of the money that we're generating put in infrastructure.
He recounted how in the 1980s he witnessed many mothers die in labor because they were reporting to the hospital very late and the staff were of low level. Ogwal says they decided to improve the level of expertise of midwives to care for the mothers and children, then find out the problem by establishing public health department.
When I worked here in the 80s, I witnessed very many of our mothers dying with deliveries because it would come very late. And also, the staff handling them at that time were at that low level, which is not bad, but they were there. Then we said, the first thing we do, we should upgrade the level of expertise of midwives who are going to look after our mothers and the children. When that was done, then what is the next thing? These mothers sometimes die because by the time they are coming to the hospital, they are really sickly.
Ogwal Okeng said he has been asked why students of Lira University are not getting loan schemes. He says this is because students apply to the university as a last resort later after the period of the loan scheme has expired.
I'm being asked, why are students not being sponsored? Students from here are not getting loan scheme. We have done our part. We have put the structure there. There are classrooms, there are programs that we have had. The programs that we run here are all accredited. And fairly, they are very, very good for development. The loan scheme, the way it operates, people have to apply to the university and we admit them.
Bosco Okelo Odon, the firm's technical director, says the project has greatly impacted the employees, some of whom have constructed their own houses.
I'm happy to inform you that the above work have been executed as per the technical specifications and drawing, with the exception of laboratory fitting, which has already been ordered for and pending delivery. The university now have the occupational permit for this building. So after handover, then you can occupy this space.
Lawrence Igole, the resident city commissioner, challenged people to promote the university by mobilizing students to join Lira University.
We are responsible for so many things that are not happening correctly in our region. First of all, we would expect 5,000 students here by now in this university. But as leaders, what roles have we played to mobilize them and bring them here?
Sam Atul, the city mayor, and D.K. Odon, the chairperson of Aleptong District, pledged to support education in the region.
Coming of this complex, we are going to do our best to make sure that we champion the cause of education in the region. It is not an easy task, but we need to take it head on.
This report was filed by Hudson Apunyo for the news.